Hi, I'm Kurt David, host of the show From Glory Days. Please join me and watch the stories of Hall of Fame, All-Star, World Champion, and former professional athletes go from the pinnacle of their pro sports careers back to normal, everyday lives. Today's guest became a member of the Soviet National Gymnastics team at the age of 12. In 1992, she competed in the Olympics and won 4 medals, including 2 gold for the team in overall events. My guest today, Tatiana Gutsu. When we come back, you'll hear Tatiana explain how she found her way from Russia to Detroit.
From Glory Days, with your host, Kurt David. Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
Gymnasco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
I'm Kurt David, and I'm joined today by Tatiana Gutsu, former Russian Olympic gymnast. Tatiana, at age 4, you fell in love with gymnastics. At age 12, you were on a national team. By age 16, you were the best in the world. What was it like to be such a young athlete and some of the most renowned in the world at that time?
I have to say that, you know, inspiration can come from anywhere, anytime, any place. And my inspiration was my parents went to Moscow Olympics, and actually they brought me a mascot from the Olympics. And I think that was just a trigger for me to start gymnastics. At the same time, at age 4, I was looking at the Olympics, and when I saw gymnastics, I just knew right then that it was my passion, and like I was so excited to start, and I couldn't even wait for me to go and start like
first
lesson.
What was the hook for you? What was it? What was it that you loved about it? What was it that enamored you so much?
Well, I have to say that, you know, who doesn't like trampoline? Absolutely everybody.
So the bouncing, as soon as you saw the bouncing,
you were
hooked.
It can be from age 2 to probably age 65 mm-hmm. or 70. So I think that was another thing for me to find something phenomenal and something different than games from outside.
Mm-hmm. And at age 12, you're on a national team, the Soviet national team, and such a young age, but yet from there you went right to the Olympics at 16 within 4 years.
Not quite. First, I had to qualify for a junior Ukrainian mm-hmm. national team, and as well as a junior national USSR team. After I think a year of making such a great job and improving myself in gymnastics and mastering the skills and everything that we put together with the coach, I think then I had an opportunity to actually step up, and I was invited to go to the Ukrainian national team as well as national team of the USSR. So it was
there were steps along the way between age 12
along
and 16.
The way,
yes.
Correct. Mm-hmm. But I think you're not paying attention at what you earn, and you're paying attention on at that time, because really I was just a child.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, very young.
What was more important? The more important was to learn skills, to get routines, to go traveling, to see the world, and that you can see your components, and with that, you sort of like you're building levels for you to strive to be the best.
So gymnastics was that tool for you. It was that avenue for you to see the world, to be the best. What drove you? What drove you to get to that level?
My passion.
Your passion for gymnastics.
My passion for gymnastics.
And that
really.
Passion, can you describe that passion for you? Is there any words you can use to describe it?
I think it's not just coming from the passion. It's coming from a team of people that surround you. I think this is most important that, you know, my parents was very supportive mm-hmm. of, my coaches, my teammates, so on with professional coaches when I reached to the national team. So it's, you know, you can sort of think of inspiration of one person, but yet really it comes from
a whole team of people
to actually build you up where you have to be.
And you got built up, European championships, and then ultimately
three
the Olympic
times.
Championship. Three times, exactly.
Three times.
European champion three times, and ultimately the Olympics and all the medals
Correct.
There in the Olympics. In fact, we have the honor of having a display here today as well.
Yes.
And so the Olympics, were they the pinnacle of your career, you think, as far as the winning the medals? Or what was the pinnacle of that career? There were so many successes. What was the pinnacle?
I think that was my ultimate goal.
The Olympics.
The Olympics was my ultimate goal. And I think I did not have find time to set another goal right after Olympics. So I think I cannot even say that I finished my career because I am still in my career, but in different field.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that later in the next segment. But so you felt like that was the goal. Like once you got to the Olympics and once you accomplished that, there really wasn't any other goal for you as an athlete, as a gymnast.
Correct.
Not another Olympic? What prevented you from having 4 years later?
I did wanted to try, but I think the transition is when you are a child and when you're growing to a young woman, I think that transition kind of slowed me down, which is now in days you can compete when you're only 16.
Mm-hmm.
Not younger than that.
So the rules were a little bit
the
different.
Rules are different.
Yeah.
Back then.
Yeah.
Yes, and now I think the rules are much better because you can, you know, the young girl can actually form to a beautiful woman and actually show her skills and show herself and what she mastered in her career and to show to the world.
And on that moment, we're going to come back to that. But when we come back from our commercial break, we're going to hear more about Tatiana Gutsu and how she went from Russia to Detroit, Michigan.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund has built a game plan to provide a legendary kind of impact that will facilitate affordable housing to those in need and help build and better the communities that surround them. Together, the United Athletes Foundation and the housing and development experts at Great Lakes Capital Fund have the power of connecting professional athletes' vision, voice, and drive with asset management and strength. With this team, everyone wins.
Big statements are made with actions, not words. Go to the guys that work as hard as you do. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer on US 23, exit 149 in Whitmore Lake. The 24,000 square foot facility performs all service applications on tractors and trailers, light duty, heavy duty, single axle, multi-axle, dump trailers, and walking floors. No job is too big or too small. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer, 734-995-9600. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer. We do it right the first time.
Do you need a proven winner? Do you want to build a better team, create stronger leaders, and face change like a champion? Kurt David works with highly successful individuals, organizations, and businesses that at times face challenges with leadership, change, and developing passion. Go to KurtDavid.com and allow Kurt the opportunity to work with you.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
I'm Kurt David, joined by Tatiana Gutsu, former Russian Olympic gymnast. The Olympics were the pinnacle of your career, but shortly after that, or how much longer after that, did you know as a gymnast, as an athlete, it was starting to become over?
I was not prepared for that, let me tell you this. In the same time of when Olympics was over, our country, went through a big changes. Mm-hmm. Yes, but I did have an opportunity to, from the 1992 to 1994, I had an opportunity to travel the world for the exhibition, and as well in 1994, we were invited to come here, which is my coaches, Victor and Tamila, and me, so we came here in 1994, and that was a new chapter of life just began.
In what way? How was it different for you coming here? Was that the first time you had left Russia? Of course, you traveled all over for the Olympics.
It was not the first time, but it was a first time for a long time.
Okay.
Correct.
And how long was it?
Well, now it's 20 years.
20 years. But
20
what,
years.
So the decision to come over here was because of the coaches being here. Was it a tour or something, or what brought
you over? I think the decision was completely mine, mm-hmm. 100%, and also my parents did support me with that decision to come here so I can find different inspiration, so I can find something different than my past career.
So your inspiration, you were looking for inspiration, you were seeking inspiration. Did you find inspiration?
I did. I'm doing lots of things that actually involve with gymnastics, mm-hmm. and not only in gymnastics. In fact, I work with two best companies in Michigan. Two of them was fined number one this year. It's Elite Michigan and Extreme Gymnastics, and I am very proud to work with those company because we have outstanding athletes, and our progression and success just beginning this season.
Mm-hmm. So you're having success now in a different world. And to back up a little bit, as far as an athlete, as a gymnast, as a world-class gymnast, what was it like to be over for you as the gymnast itself? Not only are you doing things differently now as a coach, but as a gymnast itself, as the athlete side of it, what were some of the difficulties for you?
Difficulties.
Were there difficulties?
They were.
Mm-hmm. And those were.
But you know, you have to find something positive in every day for you to strive to.
Was that difficult?
To find new dream, new passion, to find something that you can be related to. And I think what I find in me that I relate not only in sports field, but also that I can be helpful to other people.
How difficult was that to find that from being an athlete, because the focus is on you?
I think in the beginning it was the language barrier.
Okay, in what way?
In way that when I did come to United States, I just knew two words, thank you and please, that's all, hello. But, you know, now being here for so long and meeting absolutely an amazing people in the United States in over 20 years, you know, you just take best parts, best positive things from each person that I know. And, you know, I kind of like build that up into my life.
Mm-hmm. What are some of your, in your opinion, what are some of the differences between being a Russian gymnast and being an American gymnast? As far as, is there a difference, and what are those differences?
The differences are maybe just the countries, but I think as is right now, United States gymnastics American team is number one in the world, and being number one in the world for several years, which is very exciting. And, you know, I cannot choose the sites because I was born there, but I live here. Mm-hmm. Same time, I have to be cheerful for both teams.
So I'm not going to lie. Who do you cheer for, I guess, when you're watching the Olympics?
I have to be cheerful for both sides. You know, I don't take sides.
Okay. So I'm not sure how that looks when you're watching the TV when those Olympics are on, but I guess you're cheering for both sides.
You know what? I think I'm more cheerful when I watch FIFA.
When you watch what?
FIFA.
FIFA is
World
the
Cup.
Organization. Oh, okay, when you're watching the
soccer,
the
yes.
soccer, yeah.
Yes.
So that's yes. a little more safe for you, I guess, so to speak, than the gymnastics.
Correct.
So this transition out, as you mentioned, that you were inspired. That was part of your life, is being inspired. Your whole life being inspired. You're inspired by your parents. You're inspired in gymnastics. You reached the pinnacle as an Olympic athlete, and you became inspired by helping others, I heard you say.
I do. I think it's coming from a long way to from all of that support that I did earn when I was a child, and I can translate that from the knowledge that I do have. I can translate that now, and I can give some part of inspiration to the people.
Well, on that note, we're gonna have to take a commercial break, but when we come back, more from Tatiana Gutsu, and perhaps we'll get her to share who her favorite gymnast is today.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Gymnasco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund and the United Athletes Foundation have built a game plan that will create stable and sustainable communities that include affordable housing and economic development opportunities. The United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. And Great Lakes Capital Fund has a superior track record in raising capital and managing communities they invest in. Together, they raise capital to invest in the future. With this team, everyone wins.
Gymnasco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
Join me, Diana Lewis, and support Detroit Rescue Mission Ministries, which provides emergency shelter, substance abuse counseling, job training, transitional housing, and eventually to those who qualify, a permanent home so they can lead healthy, independent lives. Among those in need, military veterans, women with young children, and families. Please call the number on your screen or go online to drmm.org and donate now.
Do you need a proven winner? Do you want to build a better team, create stronger leaders, and face change like a champion? Kurt David works with highly successful individuals, organizations, and businesses that at times face challenges with leadership, change, and developing passion. Go to KurtDavid.com and allow Kurt the opportunity to work with you.
Pretty special, right? Where else can you get this?
No, pretty much anywhere.
What?
What? Oh, yeah, no, I meant Xfinity On Demand. You can get it on all your devices, anytime, anywhere. But yeah, this you can only get here. Dude, where's your horse?
Who cares?
Awesome is having the most TV shows and movies anywhere with Xfinity On Demand.
I'm Kurt David, joined with Tatiana Gutsu. Tatiana, gymnastics has been your whole life. Who's your favorite gymnast today?
I would say my favorite gymnast today is Simone Bailey. She became a world champion in China just about 2-3 weeks ago. And I am so excited to see when she's competing. It's just outstanding fireball. And
do you see a little bit of yourself in her? Is that what you think the attraction is? Or?
No, absolutely different. Mm. Absolutely different and absolutely remarkable and phenomenal girl and as an athlete also.
How do you compare her career with your career?
My career was slightly short just because of the rules of the age. And I would say that now athletes have more opportunity and more of time to actually master of what they're doing and show to the world. Mm-hmm. In fact, one of my friends from 1992, my teammate from 1992, Oksana Chusovitina, she's still competing. She's 38 years old, but she's been in 4 or 5 Olympic Games. She's been to 7 or 10 World Championship, and she's just my hero.
Is she, her body's holding up, in other words? She's still
absolutely
able to do it. You,
yes.
You tried to make a comeback. 2003, you tried to make a comeback.
I did. And I don't think it was a good choice.
No, for what reason?
Reason is, as a technique-wise, the technique was installed in me a long time ago. And as a body type, that was a little bit of difficulty.
What do you mean by body type, as far as
body type of?
Gymnastics has changed since when you were younger and now?
Gymnastics has been changed. So I tried, and it was just not for me anymore.
How did that come out that you found that out? I mean, when did you realize that? Was it through the competition itself or family?
It's not through the competition. It's been through work, because being working with kids, and every time that I would have to explain something, it would come up that I was actually showing physically. So I think that's where it came from.
Okay.
So I thought, okay, I'm going to try to see where it's going to take me. It took me about 3 months, to get back in shape, but I kind of lived it.
You had a little fire left. A little fire left, and then it went out at that
point.
And
then it just went out.
So let's talk about, you talk about working with kids. Let's talk about what you're doing today. What are you doing now?
I'm working at Elite Cheer Michigan, and last year we went to the Worlds, and from the 100 teams, we were quite a bit very close to get the first 3 places. But I think we are stronger than ever this year, and I'm anxious to start the season. Same as I'm working with the company Extreme Gymnastics. And we're just about to start our season. I cannot tell you the results, but I think it would be absolutely outstanding results this year.
You're very positive about
absolutely.
The outcome and everything.
Yes.
So you mentioned cheer, you mentioned gymnastics. What is the difference between elite cheer and elite gymnastics?
Cheer is more as dance-wise, more pyramids and transition from dance tumbling. Gymnastics, you have 4 apparatus, and like I said before in my previous interview, that you know, it takes you, it took me 10 years to get to the Olympics, but it's only 5 minutes of perfection.
What do you mean by that?
Each apparatus has certain time that you have to reach. Let's say a vault, it's only 35 seconds. Uneven bars, it's 45 seconds. Balance beam, it's a minute 25 or a minute 30, and same as floor exercise, it's 1 minute 30. So technically it's 10 years of 5 minutes of perfection.
Wow, so you really, for all that training, for that moment, so to speak.
Yes.
So what was different now between coaching gymnastics or cheer and being an Olympic athlete? What's the difference in your opinion?
Oh, it's a big difference, because when you are an athlete, you're showing what you learn. When you are a coach, you are have to find the ideas for your athletes to be one of the kind.
And you gotta do it.
That's a big difference.
As an athlete, you're doing it. As a coach, you're showing it.
Correct.
Was that a difficult transition for you?
Not at all.
For what reason?
Not at all, because I already had an experience from the best of
the coaches
in the world. Mm-hmm. In fact, those coaches are in the world somewhere else in different parts of the world to teach that best to have world athletes.
So you had some great models as a result for the coaching.
Correct.
And
yes.
So, well, we need to take another break, but when I come back, more from Tatiana Gutsu and your Facebook questions.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Gymnast Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
I'm Kurt David, back with Tatiana Gutsu, former Russian Olympic gymnast. Ida on our Facebook page wanted to know, as an Olympic gold medalist, what ways can you positively influence the youth today?
Sometimes all of us human beings have difficult times. But I think you need to find a strength in yourself to, when you stumble, you have to find the way to stand up and keep on moving forward.
What causes you to do that? When you stumbled, when you struggled, what caused you to stand back up again? What was the fire, the motivation for you?
The fire and motivation for me probably is my family.
In what way? How did your family inspire you?
When I moved here, I was only 17 years old. And just recently, about 3 years ago, my parents moved to United States. And when I saw them first time, it was such a remarkable, unforgettable moment that just the wings was attached to my body. I would say.
It was an exciting time for you.
It was
meant so much for you.
Exciting time, correct, but at the same time, you know, when you feel that family or friends or whoever is by you at that moment when you have difficult time, I think people have to be more courageous and stand up actually and help somebody.
And you've had that your whole life, your family, your coaches. This show is based on the transition of high caliber athletes, Olympic professional athletes. In your opinion, what advice would you have for anybody that's facing a transition or change?
Not to be afraid.
Not to be afraid. Simple words, but yet profound.
Not to be afraid.
Afraid of what?
Anything.
So fearless.
Human being is so powerful, and we have so much strength that we don't even know and we don't use. And I think this is just the simplicity of not to be afraid.
Great advice, great words from Tatiana Gutsu, who was never afraid, right? At any point, were you ever afraid?
Sometimes.
Okay, all right. You're going to bait us with that one then, as far as when that. So that might have to be another segment for us in the future, unfortunately.
Of course.
Because we are out of time. I'm Kurt David, and this wraps up another show. Please join us again next time as we watch the stories of professional athletes unfold from Glory Days.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Gymnast Development Company, building a brighter future today.